Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Fallout 4. And on this episode, we are going to be continuing where we left off. Now, on the last episode, we managed to find a new area to hunt. In fact, I can show you there on the map exactly where it is. It's this assembly plant right here. And there was a lot of guys inside. That's someplace we're going to be definitely checking out here in the future. I know I said we're going to try to get back there as soon as possible, but that is a very, very long run. It took me about 10 minutes to run all the way back. And it will take about, you know, half the episode to get all the way over there. So what I'm going to do is on this one, because I want to show you some of the stuff we've done inside of town, because it's been a while since I've done that. We're going to go off and explore a different area. And then on the next episode, I am going to run in between that one and this one, run over there to that assembly plant, and we'll start up there. But basically, guys, I have been just adding a few, you know, luxuries here and there as time permits. And I've kind of got things a little organized. This is my little workshop in here, so that when that green cloud comes in of radiation, I can kind of seal up all the doors. And I don't get hurt too much. There are a few holes in the walls and things of that sort. But for the majority of the rainstorm, I am perfectly fine in here. The other thing I was going to say is every so often, somebody comes over here and joins me. If I go into build mode, you can see I have 10 people now. And that's pretty cool. I mean, it just every so often, I get another worker, and sometimes they're not a worker, sometimes they're a farmer, sometimes they're a scavenger. It just seems like they show up whenever they feel like it. I like it, you know, it's definitely pretty nice, but one thing to keep in mind, though, guys, is I've been, you know, basically putting down more and more of the resources. Every time they manage to grow something, whether it's, you know, this razor grain
growing well,
or, you know, the gourds on the ground, the melons, any of that stuff, even these... These things I've actually stopped planting. I've gone ahead and started picking them all up, and I have like 60 of them over in my storage right now, but I'm no longer planting those down on the ground anymore because I don't need any more. They're just everywhere, and to be honest, there's only a few recipes that I'm even interested in using them in, and they require like carrots as one of the components, and I just now finally have managed to start growing some carrots. So let me put that one down real quick. Because I want to make sure as we get resources, I put down the ones I really, really need. And carrots is one of them right now, because we just don't have a whole bunch of them. Corn is another one, and gourds is also another one I throw in there. This is just a field of just, you know, gourds and, you know, melons all around this whole area. They've been stacked on top of each other. Sometimes you'll find areas like that that allow you to just, you know, keep putting more and more down, and it doesn't seem to affect the other ones from growing, which is just fantastic. I love the fact that I found a nice spot where I can put my stuff. We're gonna put that over here as well, and then exit out of build mode. But you'll see that you know, it's going pretty good. The farm area is going really well, and I've gotten a lot of food from it. Someday we will eventually use this food, but for now I think it's just supplying more and more people to be able to come into my camp. And all I'm doing with those people is growing more and more food, but it's kind of like this vicious circle that is getting more and more people, but in a good way, because eventually I will have enough people in my camp to start opening up shops and making money off of those shops. And from what I've been told, the more people you have, see, this is my one and only corn bush right here. We did find some wild corn, as if you guys remember one of the episodes, but wild corn cannot be planted for some reason. So this one bush right here, this one thing, I actually got off of one of the newcomers, the last guy who just showed up, the number 10th guy that just kind of got here. He had a couple caps on him, and he had a thing of corn. And so I took it off of him, and I planted it. So that was... Yeah, so that was kind of nice. I don't know if, you know, you can rely on that to be the same for you, but definitely check their inventory and see what they have. Another good thing to do, and something that, you know, I didn't really mess around with when we first started either, which is go into their inventory and give them a better weapon. Make sure you give them the corresponding ammo if you're going to give them a different weapon than what they started with as far as the caliber goes. Give them a better weapon, and then give them more clothing. The only guy I couldn't give clothing to was Sturges here. And if you go into him, let's see.
Nice job with those defenses.
Oh, you.
I've got nothing else I need right now. I think Preston may want to chat, though.
Well, I'll have to talk to him in a minute then. But yeah, I added
just
a whole
wanted to trade
bunch
a few
of defenses.
Things.
But you'll see right here, he has, You actually can't see what he has because it's like invisible clothing. It's not until you give him something else from your inventory to wear. And I don't think I have anything. Yeah, I've already gotten rid of all my stuff. But if you give him like PJs or a vault suit, it will.
People don't fix so easily.
It will take this off, and this gives him 10 defense. Unfortunately, that means he can't wear any of the other pieces of armor, the leather and all that other stuff that I can give him, that I've been getting off of enemies. But everybody else can. So, actually, not everybody. The old woman who, you know, wants nothing but jet, I can't even talk to her to get into her inventory. Everybody else, though, has the option of going into their inventory, and I've given them really, really good stuff. I think everybody's sleeping, though. Let me go look. No, nobody's over here. Where is everybody? Oh, there they are. So you can
hopefully
see
one of them synths. He had a spy on me. Life still ain't perfect, but we're surviving.
You can see they have some glasses on. I give them that. I give them some old leather. Just stuff that I've gotten off of the bandits. I've given them better weapons. Some of them have some really nice stuff. Some of them not so much. These guys, they got the leftovers. They're wearing a construction
sure,
helmet.
Let me just stop what I'm doing to talk to you.
Rather than the
being sarcastic, leave me alone.
Rather than the military helmets that I got, I've put these guard towers all over on the borders of my base so that if they get attacked, and they haven't yet. They haven't gotten attacked by anything as far as I'm aware. But these things are every so many feet. You can see they're just all around. And these are the low ones. There's only a few of the second level ones, you know, in here. I think there's only two of them, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. But this whole place is very, very well protected. This is more out here. You know, I went a little overboard with them, I think, but when I started doing that, when I started going overboard with them, that's when more of the settlers started to show up. So I'm thinking that they might correspond to just how well defended your area is. You know, the more defended it is, the more guys who feel safe showing up to your area. So I like that, and of course I like just being protected, because as I said before, if they die, I'm pretty sure you don't get them again. They're dead, and you lose out on those people from then on. So you have a nice little supply of turrets up here. And then I decided that, you know, I want my lights. I really want to, you know, have some of these buildings have lights inside, because it gets really dark here at night. And I just don't have the copper for it, to be honest, because it takes a lot of copper to build these posts and the cables. Each one of those cables cost one copper along with other materials. I did put a light here, and at night this looks really, really cool. It moves back and forth over the bridge. It took a little while to get it to line up with that bridge just how I wanted to, and I'll put another one over here when I can afford it. But for now, I am completely out of copper yet again. I just can't keep on to that stuff. This just stuff is amazing. So many uses for it, really. But yeah, I'm gonna have to drag this down from pole to pole to pole all the way down both sides of the street so that I can connect them to the houses. And in the houses, you know, I'm gonna have lights. But I went ahead and decided that, you know, my guys, they work hard. They've been doing pretty good. They deserve a place to kind of hang out and maybe, you know, relax for a little bit. So I went ahead and created a, you know, a little place for them to do just that. I got the pool table in here, and there's some chairs sitting over here. I wish I could put some, like, pool sticks, you know, right there on the wall. But unfortunately, those are weapons, and I don't know any way to put weapons on the wall just yet. I'm pretty sure there might be a way to do that, because in the intro, you can kind of see on the wall there's a mount with like guns and stuff like that. So that might actually be a thing later on that I can do once I figure it out. I also have a jukebox out here. Now, the jukebox has to have power, or close to power. So you can hear the noise, and I hope to get rid of that noise here in the future. But that's the little engine out there, the little engine that I built. And then, of course, I have one of these little things right here, these connected to it, so it's close by. But I'm going to rearrange that once I have more copper, so that this thing's further away and you won't hear it, and you know, these things are hidden so you won't see it. And then of course I have a TV I cannot activate right now because I just don't have the power close enough to it. This needs power as well, but I did activate it at one point just to make sure that it worked, and it was really, really cool looking. I like the fact that you can have a TV in here, but I think it's looking pretty nice, guys. This is a really, really comfortable place to hang out. I went ahead and put a magazine rack in here, and I put some of my books in here. I don't think you actually have to have those on you to get the bonus form, so I went ahead and put them in here because this is going to be the place that I have that. I'll also put a bobblehead thing in here eventually, and I'll put my bobbleheads on that so we can kind of show those off as we get more. I went ahead and created a little place for it to just to hang out. I haven't seen it. actually in this light, but this is actually really nice. Oh, that green rain is coming in, I think, again. But yeah, this is really cool. I like it. Yeah. And of course, you know, you can always sit down in the chair, and he actually kind of sits down and puts his feet or his legs underneath the chair right there, or underneath the table. So that came out really well. We got to get out of here though, because it's, we got to let this pass, otherwise we'll get a lot of radiation. I have waited out here, you know, on the outside when these things come by, and it's actually a fairly decent amount of radiation that you get. And there's that lady right there, the one that we found on our journey. She actually stays in here for a good bit. Almost every time I come back to town, she's here. Let me button this place up so it's nice and secure. There we go, close the doors. And now we shouldn't get radiation too much. In fact, if you enter your suit, I think you can save yourself from radiation as well. Of course, that guy had to open up the door. Ah, I hate my minions. Command. Go there,
of course, sir.
And stay there. Let me close my door. Yeah, so I am not getting any radiation in here. Let me see, if I don't move, does it drain? Nope, there is a little bit of radiation. You can kind of hear the rads move right there on the little rad meter. I wonder if it drains the core when you're not moving at all. I'm still getting rads, yeah. I'm still getting rads. Although it shows my HP meter. That's pretty cool. I had never really sat in here for a little bit of time and just kind of looked at the stuff you have in here. Yep, some more rad. So yeah, it's not perfect. It's not a perfect system, but let me see. Can I get out?
Move here.
Stop. I don't want to talk to you anymore. Stay.
Wait there.
Okay, I got it. Now, okay, there we go. Can I pop out? How about now? Nope, still can't. Oh, geez. How far do I have to get out? Okay, so now I am out of my suit, and you can see the rads are still kind of popping up. Let's see, can we get someplace a little bit rad over here? This is where I usually hang out. There's no windows for the most part, and it seems to be the safest area in the house. So you can do some weapons research, which is exactly what I think we're going to do while we wait for that storm to pass. Nope, we're still getting some rads. Let's exit out of this. Let's back up a little bit. Let's see, can we wait it out right here in the center? Right where the food is? Okay, we can make some beverages. I think we can make some purified water. Yeah, we got dirty water. Get a little bit of experience for that, so no reason not to do that. Dirty Wastelander. Mute fruit, Nuka-Cola, and whiskey. Oh, that sounds like a, you know, you mix Coca-Cola with some kind of like Jack Daniels or something like that. It kind of sounds like what that is. Throw in a little bit of fruit for a little bit of sweetness. And yeah, you got a pretty cool drink. There is one thing I want to make in here, but we just don't have enough carrots yet. We have plenty of dirty water that we find throughout the map, although I just used what I just had, but there's tons and tons in storage right now. So I can do this. I wish you could make it with just regular water, which clean water, because we got even more of that than dirty water, and it's an endless supply of that. But yeah, look at it. We have 103 of those tomatoes and potatoes, those tattoos mixed in there. Really nothing else uses this except for a few of these other recipes that use a ton of other stuff, and we just don't have any of that. We can make a utility, which is vegetable starch. This uses corn, and again, we just finally got corn. It does use purified water as well as the moot fruit, I should say, and that is something that we're just now getting a decent amount of as well. So in the future, I imagine I'll be able to sit here and just level my guy up if I really wanted to, making tons and tons of this stuff. And this stuff is an adhesive, and adhesives are somewhat rare, so this is kind of nice. My farm is going to be giving me resources, jeez guys, I cannot speak tonight, resources that I'll be able to use to, you know, make my town better in the long run. So, oh, I think the storm is finally over. Oh, and it comes out, look how beautiful it is now, the sun is out, and we are finally ready to take off. So yeah, I mean, it's just a few things here and there that I've been adding, mainly that one building that I just showed you, the pool hall. You know, I was kind of proud of that one. That one turned out, I think, the best out of all of them. But none of these things have light at night, except for that main building right there, the one in yellow. And the only reason that one has any light is because it has a few lanterns that it came with. And so it shows off, and it looks really nice. Like, the light really brightens the area up and makes it look like it's, you know, coming back to life and everything else. And that's kind of why I want to do it. I mean, it's just not really serving any other purpose other than for looks, but the looks reason is enough for me. I mean, that's, let me Let me look at my inventory, make sure we got rid of all of our junk. Yeah, we did. Okay, so we can come out here. Actually, what's my weight? 170? Yeah, that's good. We can come out here, we can look around a little bit and head off in a direction for, you know, 20, 30 minutes and just see what we can find. Let me see, where's my map? So we are heading in the right direction. Yep, this is the way we want to go. Just to kind of see what we can find. Now, the last time we did this, we found a outpost that we actually took over. I have been back to that outpost. I looked around. I tried cleaning some stuff up here and there. But for the most part, there wasn't any resources there to clean up. It was pretty well scavenged. You know, they did a fantastic job with setting that one up. And it already has a few buildings that I can have people occupy to, you know, guard the area. So that's definitely something that, you know, as soon as we can get some people out there, we're going to do, but I haven't been able to do that yet. I mean, nobody's showing up to that area because I can't put anything down because I don't have any resources. All my resources are at my main place. I wonder if I can turn this back on and get anything out of it. I don't think I can. Probably not. Yeah, I probably can't get anything out of this. But it'd be cool if I could. Maybe one day we'll figure out what to do with that. Oh, more bad guys. Oh, what are you guys doing? There? Yep, somebody is here. Right in your face. Oh, man. Jeez. Come on, there we go. Get him. Holy crap. Jeez, that is just so wicked to see. Come on, dude. Stop shooting me. You know you want to die. In your Oh my god, it's so wrong to walk up to these guys with a shotgun. It's my new favorite weapon, guys. It was not when we first started. I actually tended to like the pistol to start with, but this one has grown on me, guys. It really has. What do you got over here? And of course, you know, this loot that we get out of this area actually comes back again and again and again, as I've said before, if you leave it and wait long enough. So that's kind of cool, kind of not, depending on how you look at it. I'm going to lean towards that it's cool because I need more resources at the moment. I need a lot more resources at the moment to do what I need to do. And we lost the signal to our settlement. That's one of the other things that I've been trying. Holy crap. There we go. That's one of the other things that I've been trying to get done at these other settlements. Jeez, come on. Can I aim? I guess I can't. Come on, where are you going? Where'd you go? Oh, he's gonna dig up right underneath me. Where are you at? I know you're here. There you are. Such a better shot. Naked mole rats, guys. Naked mole rats. Jeez. Yeah, but yeah, I've been trying to build the satellite or the radio thing. Come on, where are you at? Oh, jeez. Did I get both of them? No. Well, actually, I did. I just didn't kill the second one. Oh, wow. That dude has no head anymore. Has no head. Oh, I love it. I love just the way this looks when you kill these things. I didn't at first. It was kind of creepy, but I don't know. It's growing on me. Now I actually, you know, very, very much dig it. Oh, yeah, we're going to grab that. But, yeah, I've been trying to go through this conversation, and I keep getting distracted. Yeah, trying to build those radio stations so that we can get more people, because it seems like that's the only way I've ever managed to get anybody. Misty, or the thicket evacuation. What is this? Is it right where I'm standing? No, it's a little bit off to that side. Yeah, it's right there. Okay, so let's look at that. Let's go down there and see what we can find. If it's an evacuation, oh, look at that. There's guys down there, guy. Oh, sniper. Sniper, where's my sniper rifle? Miscellaneous weapons. High capacity. We did get a new sniper rifle that I wanted to check out. This is the new one. I haven't tried it out at all. It just seems like it's going to be better. It's 46 damage versus 37, but the accuracy may not be as good. So let's try this one out. Oh, wow. That's pretty good accuracy. What do you guys think? What are the chances of me getting a headshot? Probably not that great. But then again, I don't want to kill this guy. I don't know if he's hostile. He may be a friendly guy. He doesn't have a weapon on him. It doesn't look like he has armor on him. Yeah, he may actually be friendly. So let's head down there and see if we can not get into any trouble and try not to fall down. In fact, let's save it just in case we do, because that is almost definitely going to kill me. Whatever happened to my robot? Oh, you know what? I told him to stay. I told him to stay on the, in that area. So he's not coming with me this time, unfortunately. But that's all right. I'll pick him up on the next episode. That sucks. That sucks so bad because I have a decent amount of weight on me already, and I'm probably gonna need him here. So I'll probably have to leave stuff here and then come back and get it in between. Oh man, this is cool. What is this, marble? Looks kind of like it, right? Well, there's a marble quarry. We'll definitely take advantage of that. If I could build out a marble, I mean, that's very costly and very labor intensive, but it looks beautiful, like, 'cause you can't get better than this, and it lasts for a very, very long time. That looks like clean water to me. I bet it is. I bet you can go down there and drink that. Probably not, though. I mean, there's pretty much no water in this game that you can just drink by itself. Push button. Where's that gonna go? Is it gonna go up or down? Where's that going? Is it going down? It looks like it's going down. Wow, how far down does that go? Just to give you an idea of how deep this must be, that is just nuts. Oh, what is this? Okay, let's grab all of this. Now I'm gonna push that button one more time. Oh, there it is. So it came up. Oh yeah, it's advanced. Oh crap, that is definitely not the right way. Come on. Oh, come on, a little bit more. Maybe? Oh, not enough. I wonder if you can get a better bobby pin. Like, this one seems like it's copper, it's brown. Maybe
Sweet.
there's, oh, a fuse, psycho, and wonder glue. Well, nothing fantastic, but I did get experience for opening it up. Push button. We're not gonna do that just yet, 'cause I don't have anything to give me enduring breath or anything like that, so I can breathe underwater for long periods of time. Let's come over here and sneak up on this guy. Yeah, see, he's not a bad guy. He's not a bad guy. So let's take everything this guy has. Why he's looking. Seems like he would be mad about it. I just took your tools, dude. Just took them all. And your sledgehammer. Let's talk to him.
Hey there.
Looking to earn some caps?
Sure.
I
What do
could
you
use a
got?
hand here if you're all done gawking, you know.
Ask for money, help with what? I can help.
What do you need help with?
The pump isn't in top shape, but it should at least start. There must be some leaky connections flooding me out. Think you could fix them? The leaks will be underwater. Look for bubbles, and you should find them.
Oh, yeah.
Hey.
I'm not getting enough pressure. Some of the pipe gaskets must be letting air out and flooding the pump. You see any bubbles on the surface? You should be able to follow those down to the source of a leak.
Now, I didn't ask him for money
I'm not getting enough
because
pressure.
my robot wouldn't have
Some of the
liked
pipe
it, but then I
gaskets must be
forgot
letting
that he's
air
not
out
even
and flooding
here.
the pump. You see any
So
bubbles
we
on the
should have
surface?
asked for that.
You should be able to follow those down.
I'm gonna have to look through my inventory and see if I got some kind of, something that will help me breathe underwater, because that's gonna take a. Ooh, yes. What is this?
Yes.
Permanently unlock a new, unique facial tattoo. Okay. We haven't gotten any facial tattoos before. Can you imagine putting that on your face? Jeez, you talk about being a serial killer or something right there. We could definitely go down the evil route. I wonder if you can take those off at some point down in the future, if that's a thing or not. Probably not. They probably don't have the technology to remove those. Oh yeah, take that desk fan. We need all that. Those desk fans have screws in them, and the screws in this game, guys, is used in just tons and tons of really useful stuff. I'm even actually considering going down the scrapper, line, so that we can try to, get some stuff from our armor and our weapons. Because I need that stuff so bad. There is a set of bubbles right there. Okay, let's go ahead and save it just in case I die. And let me go into my inventory. I know we had something at one time, but I may have put it all away. Okay, so let's go up to the top. We'll start here. Cures all addictions, endurance, strength, endurance. We might try that because endurance is probably going to help me out at some point while we're down there. Come on, give me something that actually does something. I think it told me what it did last time I was looking at it. So some of these don't say anything about what they actually do. Nope, it's not in there. Huh. Yeah, we're just gonna have to do it the old-fashioned way, guys. We're just gonna have to swim. This is gonna be the first time we've actually gone underwater. No, we don't want to drink the water. We do want to come over. Where's the bubbles? There they are. How far down do you think we can go? I can't even see anything. Holy crap. This is deep, guys. This is really deep. There are some bubbles right... Are these bubbles? Where's my breath? Like, how do I know if I am... If I am going to drown here? Oh, crap. I can't see anything, guys. Let's go back up. We need to find where that little set of bubbles were and come straight down. And I do apologize. We're going through we're gonna go through rads like crazy down here. Where are we at? We came over here. And the bubbles are... Man, we swam really far from where we were trying to go. Okay, straight down right there. Turn the valve. There we go. That's one. Let's look for the other one. Actually, let's look at it from up here, out of the water, because I need to get rid of some of that radiation, and we need to heal up real quick. Okay, so we got one. There's one over there. Is that one over there in the center? No, there's one over there in that corner, it looks like. Okay, so where are my rataways? There we go, minus 300. How much did that get rid of? Probably not even all of it. Yep, not even all of it. So let's drink some water. That should make us a little bit less overweight. We need to get down there. I guess we're going to have to jump. We're going to have to jump. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. So how far up do we need to go? Or how far down? Oh, come on, let me over. Stupid rail. Where are you at? There you are. Okay, we're going to get this one, and then we're going to head on over and get this one in the corner really quick, and then we got to get the crap out of that water. He said three, and this is going to be all three right here. Come on, let me get it. I'm hoping that once he does this, these valves or these tubes are going to drain this quarry so we can go down into it. I think that's what you're getting access to. So if that's the case, it's going to be definitely worth it for us to do this. But I would not be surprised, guys, if by draining the water, you lose access to some parts of that area down there, because while there's water, you can swim around wherever you want. And there may be places where the ladders doesn't connect anymore because it's just been deteriorated over time. So this may be the one and only time while there's water in it that you can access that stuff. Don't know if that's the case, but I would not be surprised. So we'll definitely check it out. And if you watch the videos, at least you'll have a heads up of where you can go, where, you know, we might just miss it or have to jump down and take that extra hit if we can survive. Where did he go? Wasn't he over here somewhere? Where's he at? He was just here. So I've done his task, and now it's time to get paid, and he's nowhere to be seen. What in the world? Maybe over here? Does he have a little place where he's sleeping? Maybe over here in this little shed. I mean, if it was nighttime, I'd understand it, but, you know, it's still daytime, and he's nowhere to be seen. So I'm going to steal everything he has as a result of that. Yes. Nope. Not gonna. Oh, wow. That one broke pretty easily. Come on. Let me open it. Yes. Oh, I love it. Got I love it. Jets and mentals. Yes, we're going to take all of that. What do we got? Chessboard? Oh, yeah. Desk fan for sure. What is this? Oh, it's a computer terminal. Yes, we are definitely open that. Stim packs. And we got to unlock his toolkit. Dang it. Oh, wow, that is really, really easy. This novice one is just a bit too easy, if you ask me now that we've upgraded. But, yeah,
That's it.
Oh, yeah, we'll definitely take the ammo. Let's see what it has on here. I'm hoping we get a nice little story out of this. Shipment log. Oh, and there's plays of tape, yes. 8-16-77, 315 tons, tables and tops. Okay, so Rochester, New York, they're going to be making tables and tops out of this marble. 8-23-77, 250 tons, pillars and pushers, Damascus, 9-15-77, 275 tons, interior slabs, 10-17-77, 240 tons, top drawer living. Yeah, this is pretty nice. They're selling quite a bit, except for right here at the end, the 10-23-77, they only sold 108 tons, ornate obelisk. That's kind of weird, right? Why would somebody buy an obelisk? I don't know. Let's play the tape. Okay, so we got different logs on here. Let's listen to what he has to say. This is a great spot. With the right crew, I'd have no problem keeping this place locked down. Traders run close enough for easy pickings, but not so close that we end up skinned. The whole darn thing filled with water, though. Figures, there's always a catch. Yeah, big-ass drainage pump looks mostly intact. If I'm lucky, it might still work. Gonna take a closer look tomorrow. Ooh, that might be the guy we're working with. He doesn't sound too good. Nope, gonna be that easy. Still, pump is in better shape than you'd think. I'd like to head back and grab some tools, but it's pretty late. I'll tinker with it some before I bed down tonight, then head out in the morning. What's he gonna say now? Shouldn't be too hard now. Glad I grabbed that sledge, even if it was a, you know, to carry all this way. Things were rusted tight. Few good whacks with the sledge cleared that problem right up. Thing made the darndest sound each time, though. You'd swear something was moving around in there. Oh, no. Yeah, there's gonna be something in there. Was able to make most of the connections. Patched up all the pipe leaks I could find, besides the ones in the water. All those noises I've been hearing, I'm not setting foot in there. I'll probably head back and drag one of the new guys over here and make him do it. And that's exactly what he just did. You are something else. Let's eject that. We're gonna take that with us. Huh. Can we listen to that? I mean, it's a holotape. So it's in what? Mods, ammo, miscellaneous? The holotape. Where are you? I don't see it in here. There it is, Sully's journal. Can we listen to it? Oh, so we can just read it. So there's actually no voice to it. I thought there'd be something to it. So this guy is not going to be the one that we thought he was going to be. And now he's gone. Now he's, what, waiting for us somewhere to attack? He should be here on the map, dude. Where'd you go? I want my money. I want my money now. Oh, if my robot was here, he'd find him. That dude finds everybody. He goes charging after him, even when I can't see him. There he is. There you are. Okay, what do you got for me, man?
Hi. That's a ticket. You do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump.
Look at that. That does not look appetizing, guys. I don't know what that is, but it looks like something that you'd get in a hospital after, you know, it's come out of like 14 people and they've been cleaning up or something. That looks disgusting. Okay, where's the button on this pump? Is it over here? No, that's not the button. Nah, come on. Don't make it hard on me. There we go. Yes.
That's done. Just listen to her go. Quit. Did you hear that?
No, I didn't hear anything. Okay. Yep, I did hear something. Oh, come on. Oh, leave me alone. Oh, crap. There's more than one. Oh, no. Get away. Get away. Ah, crap. These guys are tough. Oh, get away from me. Get away. Oh, yes. Nice. Where did they come from? I mean, they have to be down there because they're protecting their young, but... Jeez, I didn't even see them pop up.
Excuse me.
Meyer lurks. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that stirred him up. Anyway, I still got some tinkering to do on this thing. Shouldn't be too hard now, though. Thanks for pitching in. Here's a little something before you clear out.
Before I clear out, hey, I'm staying here, man. Pull the plug. Wonder if we come back later on and this whole place will be empty. Can we talk to him again?
Hey there.
You mind? I'm busy here.
Don't make me slap you, because I will slap you. Deactivate it, man. Deactivate it. This whole place is mine now. I guess we can't do anything more with it, huh? Let me go over here and see if we can see the water actually draining down, because I would not put it past the game programmers to actually let you sit here and watch it happen, but in slow motion, because it seems like, you know, the players that show up to your town, they show up in a 24-hour period. They have a chance to show up in a 24-hour period, I should say. And, you know, it just seems like if you're on, instead of going to sleep over and over again, because that's what my brother does. He just goes to sleep, gets rested, and goes back out and fights a little bit more. I sit over there and I mess with my town. I build stuff, and it seems like I get more people because he's only gotten 6 people with his, and I've gotten 10 already. So maybe that might be the case, you know, if you sit there and actually watch it. But it doesn't look like it's draining, does it? Not really. Does it look like it's going down to you guys? If it is, it's going down so slow, I can't tell. But we'll definitely come back at a later date and maybe just see if we can go back down there, because there's a lot to be had in this area. What's he doing over there? He's evil too. You know he's going to be evil. But I cannot wait. This is going to be pretty sweet. Okay, let's look at the map. What do we got in this area? We can keep going over here to this tower. The reason I was heading over here to this tower is, one, we knew there was other stuff there. We didn't quite clear everything out. And there was another sentry turret over there as well. So I knew if we headed over there in that direction, we'd eventually find something pretty cool. Plus, on the way back, if you guys remember, I tried to cut across the land. And I was almost dead. And I didn't have any health packs or anything like that that were left. And I almost died, because there was a lot of stuff in the way. So again, I knew there was going to be things that we could find over here, and is within our kind of range to do it. Is there going to be anything in here? Ooh, there is. What? One round? That's it? That's it. That's all you put up here. You guys. Man, what is wrong with you? Why would you do that to me? Let's see. Harvest. Yeah, we're going to harvest all this stuff. At least we got something out of that. Really? Just one bullet? That's all you're going to put up there? Man, these programmers, they got a sick sense of humor is all I gotta say. I'm not gonna fight that guy. That guy's a pain in my butt. Let's keep going this way. I do love the landscape as you get a little bit further out here. Almost looks like it's fall. You see all these, like, brownish colors. Where are you at? There you are. I hate you. I hate these guys. Kill them! Oh, but I love my shotgun. I absolutely love that gun. Oh, not another one. Come on. Get him! Nothing left. Absolutely nothing left of that guy. I get so many rounds for this gun, or I've gotten so many rounds for this gun, I don't even need to worry about running out. And to be honest, he kills things either in one or two shots with this for the most part, unless they're pretty tough. And if they're pretty tough, I will usually... Do I hear gunfire? No, that's just me walking. I thought I heard gunfire there for a second. But usually if they're that tough, I'll switch over to a different weapon, maybe a sniper rifle or something along those lines. But yeah, it's just, this thing is massively strong, and I cannot imagine really switching over to any other weapon anytime soon. Although I will, simply because I know you guys want to see what the other ones have to offer. And so do I. I kind of like playing around with them. Because at the time when we switched over to the shotgun, I was not really happy about that. I didn't really want to do it. I liked my handgun just fine. I thought oh, what are these guys? Is this another one? Kelly.
Excuse me.
But hold up a minute. I've got a really top-tier piece of cow flesh for sale, if you know what I mean.
Whoa. Oh, who's attacking? Who's attacking? Up here? Caravan guard? No? Huh. Were they attacking? Oh, it looks like they were taking those dogs. Okay, so let's take a look at what she has for sale.
Oh, hey. Did you think it over and change your mind?
Maybe. Belongs to you? Buy Barum for 100 caps?
Does this Brahmin really belong to you?
What do you think? It's stolen or something? Nah, she's mine. Of course she's mine. Could be yours, too, for a very reasonable price.
What for?
What would I do with a Brahmin?
What would you do with a... Oh, you're serious? Well, whatever you want. Some people use them for farming, I hear. Increases productivity quite a bit. That's what I hear, at least.
Okay, well then, what do you guys think? Should we do it? I guess we should do it. 100 caps
sure.
Is that much.
I'll take her.
Oh, great, great. Just tell me where you want me to send her, and she's all yours.
Nice. Sanctuary Hills sounds good to me. Yeah, confirm it, baby.
Good doing business with you, man. I'm sure I'll see you around.
Nice, that is fantastic. Hey, what else you got?
Next time I see you, we can do business.
All right. Now, what about you guys over here? What do you guys got? You got some meat on the ground. Where's that guard? I want to talk to him. He might have something for me. Where are you at? This is why I travel instead of fast travel, because these guys are just wandering the desert. And so are other NPCs out there. And if you don't, you know, run across the continent back and forth, you won't find people like this. You'll miss them completely. I don't know if that Brahmin is stolen. I don't know.
I'll have more products soon. Don't worry.
I don't know if it's going to really do anything for us in the long run, but it's just kind of neat to find things like that. And I definitely really, really kind of get a lot of enjoyment from finding things that a lot of other people don't, because they just don't take the time to do it. And, you know, I do get that once you've run across a place, you've kind of seen it already, and you really want to sit there and, you know, do it over and over and over again, at least for some people. But, you know, for me, I don't really have that part of me that says, you don't need to do that again. Because I'm used to playing old school video games where you kind of get punished a little bit in the sense that you don't have fast travel. You don't have the ability to go very quickly from one area to another area. And so, Tempest Bluffs, nice, we found something else. You don't have that ability to sit there and say, I'll just jump back and forth very quickly. No, you have to sit there and think about it. You're like, do I really want to make that travel over there? What are these guys? Rad Roach, Caravan Guard, Lucas Miller. Okay, so there's some people over here. Let's put our gun away. Let's save it real quick, because it's been a while since we saved it. And let's talk to these people up here. What do we got? Caravan Guard?
The only way you get old in this job is assume everyone's out to kill you.
I bet in this world.
Hi.
Best way to spend your caps is protecting your hide with my armor. That advice is free.
Oh, what's for sale?
What kind of stuff do you have?
I sell armor for Old Man Stockton's outfit, based out of Bunker Hill. Been selling armor to smart wastelanders for years. The dumb ones walk away empty-handed, but they don't stay dumb long, if you catch my meaning.
Unsure. Let's see what you got.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
What you see is what you get.
Okay, what do we got here? Baseball uniform, champion left arm. What is that? Plus one strength and endurance for 482 caps. Do we have anything to sell this guy? We do have a few pipe pistols. How much you want for those? Pipe revolver, we'll sell you that. Double barrel shotgun, we can sell you those. We can sell them that as well. Sledgehammer, that's actually really nice. 39 damage. I think that's the best one we found so far. I'll sell the tire iron then. And let's see, what about... Yeah, we can sell all this junk. We don't need any of this. Long johns. Oh, yeah, this actually clears up quite a bit of weight that I was worried about. So we get 135 out of that, which is all the caps he has. And we actually probably get a little bit more. Plus 347. Dang, that is expensive. That's more than the freaking thing was. How much was he charging for that? Let's go back to all my items. Come on, where's my items? All my inventory, there you go. Value is 147? Are you kidding me? Oh, wow, that is nuts. So he's charging as 135 plus 347 for this thing. Wow, this guy just rips you off, doesn't he? I guess we gotta do it, because that's the best item I've seen so far. And I have the money. It's not really that big of a deal. Oh, wow. He got some other stuff, too. Let's see. 10% chance to disarm melee attacks on hit. Oh, that's kind of cool. And it has really good defense. Wow. Look at how much he's charging. 10,919. That is just insane. Let's look at that. Yeah, he's actually charging that amount. Wow. If you can steal from this guy, this is the guy to do it from. Unbelievable. Oh, and he got something else here, right? Super mutant by 15%. Nice. Holy crap, guys, this is amazing. We're gonna buy what we can. Whew. Wow, expensive dude. We'll have to come back to this guy and get his other stuff at some point. Let me put that on. Cost me enough, that's for sure. Where is it at? It better be better than what I have. Yeah, it's definitely better, and it's not even upgraded yet. Strength and endurance, plus one. Wow, look at that, 15. The other one is 7, and that's fully upgraded. And oh man, that is amazing. Can I see what that looks like? Where is it at? I don't really see it on my guy, but that's his suit right there, guys. I'm not really a big fan of where it goes underneath his butt. It looks more like a diaper or something like that. But yeah, and then of course his vault suit. That's the best suit that I've found so far. The other ones, they really don't add, you know, too much protection. They add a little bit more, defense. They add like 2 or maybe 3 defense, but that's pretty much it. And I don't really care for that myself. So, what about you? Can we talk to you?
Too many miles on the road.
Excuse me.
Too many miles on the road.
Really use your help. At least the pay is terrible.
Oh, what do you need?
I'd be glad to help if I can.
We got a nest of some nasty bugs just around the corner, and if they don't get cleaned out soon, we're gonna have a real problem.
Well, what's really too bad is it'd be a nice spot for a new settlement. And in fact, I know some folks that'd love to set up there if it was safe. If you can make sure the old workshop there is still in one piece, anyone who decides to move in later will be able to rebuild.
Nice. Well, where are they
Where
at?
Is this place?
We have a pretty good idea. I hope you can find them and wipe them out. Watch your back.
Okay, so we got something there. You aren't allied to the settlement. Okay, so we actually have to go do that quest they want us to do before we have access to this area. That's not too bad. But we'll have to remember that because, yeah, we're going to go ahead and end the episode here, guys. I do want to thank you all for watching. If you do enjoy these videos, be sure you hit that like button, subscribe. Definitely helps grow the channel, guys, and I greatly appreciate it. Also, make sure to leave those comments down below because I love hearing back from you guys on what you want to see in the future and what you guys think of the playthrough so far because, holy crap. There we go. Ah, man. Am I having to waste ammo on these things? Die. Die already. Oh, man. This thing's actually taking some hits. That's nuts. Let's bring it back. See if they kill it for me. Yeah, there you go. How do you like them apples? Holy crap. I did not throw a grenade.
For now.
Oh, wow. I didn't think I had grenade equipped. Do I? I do have a grenade equipped. How'd that happen? I don't like that. I don't like how those things can get equipped without your knowledge. That could have been very, very bad had these guys been close enough to me to get hit by that. So I'm glad I kind of saved it right there just in case. But again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will definitely catch you all next time.